And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden.
All right, everybody. So we're back here with some more Madden. And I haven't had the greatest luck past three games, especially that last one. So, all right, here we go. Try to avoid a complete disaster like that last game. Can't believe it. I lost that the last 30 seconds. That's bullcrap. He threw it. Two lucky passes. I can't believe it. Alright, here we go.
Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. They come out here in the eye. The first carry now. This is
Oh man. Dang it.
He gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. From the shotgun, it's Rivers.
Wow.
Nearly picked.
That's not how I wanted that to go at all. Darn it.
Oh man, that was close.
Wow.
Momentum, big play right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense as that fell harmlessly to the ground. Rivers now, and he fires one, but incomplete.
Darn it.
Jordan Reed was the intended target, and it brings up fourth down. Now the former Gamecock, Spencer Lanning, on to punt it away.
Through the trash.
A 48-yard punt, 7 on the return. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. On first down, Tannehill. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end. A guy that you can line up anywhere. In the slot, out wide, in tight. Doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch.
Oh, come on. Really?
It's caught. It's a touchdown.
That's... Wow. Really?
With an acrobatic catch. And the Broncos have taken the early lead.
Sometimes when I see these types of plays executed, I think of basketball. Guys boxing other guys off to go out and get a rebound.
And he got the rebound right there. But the defense was really placed well.
Yeah, they were right there. I mean, that's where it's really tough for a defender. When you're in the right spot, you're draped on the guy catching the ball, yet he still comes down with it.
And now out come the Patriots. And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
You idiot. Come on. Great. Freaking start with the drops, of course.
Yards still left on second down. To throw is Rivers. Screen play, Johnson.
Oh, I almost got through there.
Screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson.
There we go.
He's got a first down as he's up to the 48. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Everyone understood their role on that drive. Third and one. You know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive linemen, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
So Herman Moore, his first grab of the game, and back in his day, he shattered all the Lions' receiving records.
And he did it with a number of different quarterbacks. He was the target for defenses to adjust to. And I guess the best way to put it is, Herman Moore, that guy...
Come on, what was that?
And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver.
Oh.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver.
Yardage here, knocked back to the 19-yard line. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
But when it comes to the running game, the New England Patriots, they're one of the few teams in the NFL that I don't think care much about balancing things out.
Last year, to your point, fifth in passing yardage, number 30 in the run game.
What they want to do each
week
is make a game plan based on their opponent, not so much their own personnel, and they try to attack that way.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. They go play action here on first down.
There we go.
Touchdown grab, and the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown.
All right, now hoping my defense can actually do something this time.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan.
Nice.
But there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. 8 yards to go here on second down. They'll fake the handoff. Now Tannehill. Escaping the pressure right. And this one caught.
Oh my god, I hate that play so much.
Shy of midfield all the way to the 49.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Fresh set of downs here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get this one down to the 45. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, He's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
So the offense readies for a second and four. Out of the gun, Tannehill. Caught on the left side, Fitzgerald. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
When you decide to run a hitch route, it really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
On first down, it's Tannehill.
There you go.
He's gonna go down. Tannehill sacked. The former Broncos scored a touchdown for him in the Super Bowl. Malik Jackson in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. On second down, Williams. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. He lost 2 there, and it's third down. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Hey, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? And almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front?
That was close.
Creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility. And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
He'll field it in the end zone. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Pats will take over at their own 20. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drives.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense has it first and 10. On first and 10, Rivers. He's got Floyd on left. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Second down, Rivers. Dumping it off for Johnson. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line.
Now, all right.
Here, we're going to get a timeout by the offense.
Got to get at least a decent-sized pickup here.
As we head toward halftime. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Rivers now to throw on first down. Caught on the right side, Reed. 23 yards on the play. A nice little completion there by Phillip Rivers. And you and I were. And now we don't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And Catanzaro's kick is right through.
Nice. That was a close one. I didn't know if I was going to make that one or not.
Field goal here at the end of the second quarter and take the lead into the lockers.
And isn't that what every team wants to do right at the end of the half? Put points on the board and go into the locker room feeling a lot better about themselves.
And Denver getting set to take the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
The final shot here before the break. Tannehill looking here for Smith downfield.
That was close.
So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Fielded about a yard deep. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two, and that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They run it again with Williams. And he'll get this up only
there
about
go.
33. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at six.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
To throw is Tannehill.
Oh, darn it.
Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up a fourth down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball.
Oh my God, I can't believe I just did that. Oh, he got it anyways.
And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Let's go, defense. Hey, dagger.
On first and 10, Tannehill. And Steve Smith hauls it in. It's a gain of 9 yards. And that'll make it second and short.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed. And they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Backing up. He's going to air one out. Did he drop it? He dropped it in the end zone.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. Are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Huh?
Ball and no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a fourth and one.
That was a terrific job by the defense stopping them on third and short. But sometimes you get some visual cues from the offense, because when they're going in short yard situations, you might see the offensive line come in tighter together, a little more shoulder to shoulder, trying to wedge a hole in the middle. They didn't get it done on that play.
Come on! Oh.
First down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
God damn.
It's a gain of 5, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. And the offense lining up first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roll. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. In the slot on the right is Graham. Throwing on third down, Tannehill. A dump off to Elliott. Picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. Back now in Foxborough. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. So here we go, first and 10 now. They'll come out in the pistol. Now a play fake here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time, spectacular plays, that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we have to...
Yes!
And it's intercepted. Picked off, it's the Pro Bowl, and now nothing but green ahead.
Ah, I cannot. I don't know, that was my fault. Darn it! Some reason I kept leaning left for some reason. God dang it. Man, that was my fault. Couldn't believe that.
The first down carry here for Johnson. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. That's gonna go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead.
I especially screwed myself up. I don't know, I was having issues with the stick.
Keep it going. But you gotta figure now, they're gonna see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Got a man and he hits him in stride. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
They'll run it with Johnson. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back under here.
Dang it.
And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
Hey, here we go. Dissect me, 80.
Third and short yardage, Rivers. Jordan Reed has it. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the touchdown as he's tackled at the 1.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
That's so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm going to try to manage the clock a little bit better this time around than I did the last time.
Get away from them.
Play clock winding down. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. First and goal. They'll look to smash it in. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. David Johnson taking it in from a yard out. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a 2-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball.
And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense.
Man, coverage definitely working pretty well this game. Quarter of play. I guess it just determines on your opponent.
Tannehill.
Oh, I almost had that interception.
It brings up third.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about big man wins in the trenches. Most like that in just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
Oh, snaps.
And that should do it. Adrian Amos with a pick.
Obviously disappointing, but...
Alright, finally made up for the past freaking couple of losses I had, jeez. Alright guys, peace out.